I have two surprising facts about Excel tables that I've learned today. Can an Excel table include a merge cell? This question from Uncle S. On an old video, 2349, insert a row, an Excel formula automatically copies. That showed two different methods to have a formula copy to a new row. One is using a table, and Uncle S says, I can't create a control T table because it would unmerge the cells, and I need to keep those. So, you know, let's try method one. You know, why is that not working? We have extend data range formats and formulas. That's file options advanced. And what is supposed to happen, we have here 1, 2, 3, 4 identical formulas. To make this work, I type the new row, I type the value 140. As soon as I press enter, that formula copies down. All right, so why is that not working for Uncle S? Well, if we come out here and type Chris and 120, it doesn't work because there's only two in a row. All right, so I copy the third one down. Now, I've always thought it's supposed to be three in a row. When I try and do the fourth one, it doesn't work. But if I have four in a row, then it starts working. The other reason that it could happen, see, if the formulas aren't all the same, if we have a plug number here, and if I come here and type flow 150, even then it's working. I would have thought that with a wrong formula, it would have not worked. So that's not it. Now, Uncle has mentioned that he has a merge cell. I don't use merge cells at all. I hate merge cells. Is that causing the problem? So Flow Smith at 150, all right? It's not that kind of a merge cell that would cause a problem. However, what if he's merged cells vertically? So what if Jack and Jill are a team and their sales are reported together? Now what we have is a formula in T4, the same formula in T5, a formula in T6, but there's nothing in T7 because T7 doesn't exist. Does that cause it to stop working? So we come here, flow 150. Yeah, so that, you know, that's essentially a blank cell. And my workaround for this would be not to put those two people on two rows, Jack and Jill. If you really want them to appear to be on two rows, right here between Jack and Jill, press Alt and then Enter. And that creates a cell that's double high, and it will give you the same look as your merge cell. All right, so that's all troubleshooting method one. But the real question today is, can a control T table include a merge cell? All right, so if I come here and do control T, see, it unmerges that cell. It's no longer a merge cell, and we don't have the same look that we had. Again, I'm not sure why you're trying to merge cells, but here is an interesting workaround. So let's take this cell that's a merge cell, and I am going to unmerge the cell, but have it have the same look. So I have both columns selected, come here to the alignment dialog launcher, uncheck merge cell, but replace it with this great setting under horizontal called center across selection. Click OK. See, now we get the exact same look, even though there's really nothing in that cell. So share appears there. It has the same look as the merge cell. And then control T. And it continues to center, right? So can a table include a merge cell? No. But can a table include center across selection? Amazingly, it can. Yet another reason why the hard to find center across selection setting run circles around the very easy to find merge and center. All right, so my first surprising thing is center across selection is allowed in tables. Here's another one that I actually learned last week. This is a great Spanish language site. Ishmael Romero, who runs the Excel 4.0 site, discovered this one. So we have an existing table here, and of course we all know that if we type 140, that 140 becomes part of the table, right? The table will grow vertically. That's not surprising, I knew that. But if you add more data to the right, the table's also going to grow. And again, I conceptually knew that. But here's the wild thing. The heading that's right above the 100 is something that's in the custom lists. So File, Options, Advanced, scroll all the way down to the bottom and edit custom lists. Of course, we have Jan, Feb, Mar, April, May as a built-in custom list, or even it works with these custom lists down here, East, Central, West. All right, if the last heading cell is from a custom list and I type a new value here, the table is going to grow, but it automatically picks up the next custom list item, which is pretty amazing. Right here, let's even try this. I'll put east, which is one of my custom list items. One, go to the right, I get central, and then west. What a crazy feature that they programmed in. Apparently, it's been there for quite some time. So thanks to Ishmael for that awesome trick. If you speak Spanish, check out his Excel 4.0. Great tutorials in Spanish. Well, hey, I want to thank Uncle S for sending that question in. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2022, Boosting Excel. Lots of great new tips. Click the I in the top right-hand corner for more information about that. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.